Hi everybody. On December 18th, I became 4 years natural. Over the course of that journey, I have had ups and downs. Some of you know that in February of this year, I trimmed like 3 inches of my hair off. So I probably don't look like I'm 4 years natural because a lot of people equate how long you've been natural with how long your hair is. And I don't think that's a fair assumption of how long a person has been natural. Not everyone's goal when they go natural is to grow their hair to armpit length or waist length or mid-back length or butt length or whatever. A lot of people there are people that go natural because they're tired of the harsh chemicals. They want to see how far their hair is going to grow, but you know, it may be in a person's DNA to not just have that really long hair. And I think maybe I'm one of those people, but anyway. I wanted to share some information with you in reference to locks because I was thinking about my natural hair journey. And when I first went natural, one of the things I did was I read natural hair books such as Ultra Black Hair Growth 2, Grow It by Chicoro, of course, The Science of Black Hair, The Naughty Truth. So I read books like that during the beginning stages of my journey and in the middle of my journey to learn about natural hair and how to care for it. And one of the things that I noticed since I've gone locked, and I've been locked, well, I'm not fully locked, but I've been on my lock journey since July. So this month makes 5 months on my journey. I have not personally come across any videos with anybody talking about books to read about a lock journey and how to care for your locks and things like that. So 2 weekends ago, I purchased 3 books on my Kindle, and I actually read all 3 of those books on the same day that I bought them. And I just wanted to share with you 3 books that I recommend that you check out if you're on your lock journey, especially in the beginning stages of your lock journey, that may help you out. So the first book is called Locks for Life: The Route to Well-Being for African American Women. And the cover looks like this. The book is by Kalima Johnson. She's also called Lock Mama, if I remember correctly, because I did read 3 books in the same day. She's based out of Detroit, Michigan. And the book covers how to start locks, like the methods that are used to start locks, such as 2-strand twists, comb coils, or braids. Talk about the lock stages, like the baby lock stage, the teenage stage, the mature stage, and I forgot the last stage. And then like your overall well-being, like things to eat to help nourish your body as well as your locks. And then the book has tons of pictures of individuals who have been locked. They talk about their lock journey. A lot of them had their locks started by Lock Mama, aka Kalima Johnson, who wrote the book. And I really enjoyed that portion of the book. So the next book I want to recommend, I'm going to pull the cover up here, is called Back to Basics: Getting Back to Starting and Maintaining Classy Locks, the natural, affordable, and simple way. This book is by Astrid Arthur. This is what the cover of that book looks like. Now, to be honest, out of the 3 books that I read, I liked this one the best. I don't know why. I think it spoke to me a little bit more. I'm just looking at my notes here. In the beginning stages, the author talks about like self-image and beauty standards, society's standards of beauty when it comes to the straight hair, the long hair, and you know, the pains that we go through in order to achieve those standards of beauty. A breakdown of what hair is, which she referenced from The Science of Black Hair. Of course, how to start locks and the lock stages. So this is another book referencing some of the same things that Locks for Life referenced. Also, lock maintenance. Basically, tips like using transparent shampoo, not to use any shampoo that might be like creamy shampoo. Yeah, that might be white, that can cause buildup. You want to use transparent shampoos. Ideas on how to make your own shampoo using Castile soap, using vegetable oil and aloe vera gel as a conditioner, and a recipe on how to do that. Using apple cider vinegar rinses to clarify your locks. And also, I think from what I read, helps with the lint and certain buildup in your locks. And then using an organic gel, or using like an organic, a virgin type oil, like extra virgin olive oil or extra virgin coconut oil for your retwists. And it does even offer, also has like a lock regimen summary, which I really liked, and lock rules, things like how often to retwist, your locks will break if you retwist every week. Don't wash your hair when you first put your locks in. You can wash your hair when you first get your locks. There's methods on how to wash your hair, like using a stocking cap and spraying, using a spray bottle such as this one with water and shampoo, because that's what's in this one, to spray it on your hair, and just kind of massaging your scalp and just rinsing your hair off when it's in the when you have the stocking cap on. Just trying to find what works for you. You know, everybody has their own method of doing things. We don't have to do or take care of our hair in the manner that everybody else does. I'm starting to find that I may have to start washing my hair more often. I washed my hair after 2 weeks because when I did my retwist using the Eco Styler or Eco Styler, is it the olive oil gel? Yeah, the Eco Styler olive oil gel. For some reason, when I did my retwist, after about 3 days, my scalp was itching and it was burning, and I made it 2 weeks, but after that 2 weeks, I shampooed my hair. I'm also starting to notice, I don't know if you can see anything, but I'm starting to notice that my scalp is a little more drier. Like, there's no product in my hair because I shampooed my hair, and then I put a flat twist in to do a flat twist out, and I've been wearing flat twist outs all week, but this one I didn't retwist, so it kind of looks a little weird. But and other people refer to this look as the beach wave look, but I call it a flat twist out. But I think I'm gonna have to start washing my hair. I think I might have to go back to washing my hair every week, which means if I decide to retwist every week and I don't see any issues with it, then that's what I'm going to do. You know, I had went back and forth between, in the beginning of my journey, doing it weeks 3, 5, and 7, and then starting to wait every 4 weeks and then stretching out to 5. But I don't think I'm gonna be able to do that anymore because I'm starting to have some scalp irritation. So, you know, just finding things that work for you. Sorry I got off subject. But yeah. And I want to backtrack because something I forgot to mention about the Locks for Life book. It does talk about remedies on product buildup, and that was the one thing I left out. All right, so the next book I want to talk about and recommend for you is called Lock Journey Basis. It's by J. Jolaine Allen, and I'm going to pull up the cover of that book for you. And this is what that book looks like. All of these books are less than 100 pages, which probably would explain why I finished all three of them in one day. They all have the same thing. One of the things that this book recommended is if you're thinking about locks, do your homework. Do your research, checking blogs, looking online at videos on YouTube. She talks about nutrition as well and how it affects your locks, things to do to prevent lint. So she has lists of YouTube producers. She talks about Lock Appreciation Day and how that was something that was started by a QO chemist. And if you get the electronic version of this book, let me see if I can go to it. Each individual that she mentions, that she recommends as a source of information, is, they actually have their hyperlink in the actual book. So she has an additional resources page. So these are all hyperlinks. So you can click on these hyperlinks to go to the website or the YouTube page that she recommends. And she even has a list of books in here. So anyway, that's what I wanted to share with you. If any one of you have read any books out there in reference to caring for locks and tips on how to just make sure you have healthy locks and things like that, leave a comment below. Also, there's one book I want to buy. It's also by the same lady that did The Naughty Truth, and it's called The Naughty Truth, and it has something to do with locks. It's like a 200-page book, and I want to buy that book. It's a hardcover, though. It's like a $25-$26 book, but eventually, I want to buy that book as well. So anyway, that's it, and then really quick, this is a flat twist out. It actually looked so much better yesterday, but I went to bed and didn't retwist because I don't have to go to work today because it's Christmas, so why not? So I'll just take a moment to do a 360 so you can see my hair. The flat twists, I've been redoing them every night, so it really has stretched my hair and stretched my new growth. As you can see, my new growth is really stretched out. So yeah, it might look like a mess in the back. So that's it. Hope this video was helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye.